guess so let's start with injury situation right now. I guess how are you guys holding up at this point?
You know, this part of the year, everybody's sort of nicked and bruised, and you just got to fight through it. You got to get multiple treatments a day, and you got guys now trying to play different positions and multiple positions based on, you know, who gets hurt. So it's all across the country. It's not just us.
KJ Dillon, after the game, pretty outspoken, saying they're going to have to drag me off the field. Is it shoulder injury with him right now?
He's been battling some things throughout the year. I don't want to specify on what it is, but he's, you know, he's battling through. He's got, you know, 5 regular season games left, and it means a lot to him.
Coming up against a Texas Tech offense like this, I guess Hogerson was saying that Gibby's pulling his hair out right now. What do they present that's so tough?
The same thing the last 3 opponents did. You know, it's the same tree. It's the same Mike Leach, you know, disciple where you're going to get the ball thrown all over the yard, and then they'll spread you out and they'll run the ball. It's no different than what we've seen the last 3 weeks. It's just, you know, different people doing it.
Special teams-wise, Grant's certainly a headache, isn't he?
Yeah, but again, it goes back to, you know, we faced a guy from Oklahoma, faced a guy from Oklahoma State, the guy from Baylor, and the guy from TCU. They were all special. I think our coverage units, knock on wood, have been pretty good up to this point. I think we're 1 or 2 in net punting and 1 or 2 in kickoff coverage, and that's a credit to not only Nick with the ball placement, but with the other 10 guys covering.
After watching some of the tape, have you seen anything that you think you can capitalize on against Texas Tech?
In the kicking game?
Yeah. Or just, I mean, special teams in general.
Well, I just think, you know, what we do on special teams is try to find a weakness of our opponent and attack that weakness, and that holds true every week. As far as on defense goes, we just got to do what we do and just perform. I mean, it's whatever defense we have called, if it's man, if it's zone, we just got to execute the call, and we have to be better tacklers. That's the one thing I think we've slipped on the last couple of weeks.
What makes Mahomes so good? I mean, he's a bigger body back there, kind of sling it all around.
Yeah, he's comfortable, got a strong arm. He throws from all angles, not like Boykin, but he throws from all angles of his body, front foot, back foot, side foot, falling over, you know, leaning, and he gets it there. So, but, you know, he's taking some chances with the ball, and he's throwing it up there to some people. We just got to, you know, catch him when we get that opportunity.
You look at all their games, it's been absolute shootouts. So what makes you think this time around the defense could step up and stop him?
That's why we practice. Hopefully our guys will take that challenge, and you know, their offense hasn't been as explosive on the road as it has been at home, and maybe that we can work that to our advantage. Hopefully the fans will come out and support us and support our kids and send our seniors off on a good note.